every time you run an app on your cell phone, it is using current. And as it is using current, you're draining the battery. We are trying to double the energy density or the capacity of the currently used lithium-ion batteries. In the first area for energy storage, most of my work currently is in the lithium-sulfur battery area. In the case of electric vehicle, the whole goal is to make the battery match the internal combustion engine. In one charge, basically, you would like to also get close to 300 miles. Higher energy, more powerful batteries, and we are trying to overcome that with advanced materials that can make it more safer, better, and more efficient. Anything that is good always has problems, and that's what we see with the lithium-sulfur batteries. In a typical battery, you have a positive terminal, a negative terminal, and then you have a medium through which the lithium ions propagate, and that's known as an electrolyte. Trying to make a polysulfide-resistant electrolyte, try to make a cathode material that will confine the polysulfides and make an anode system that will not form dendrites. So these are the three big areas that we are currently working on, which is a near-term challenge. The long-term challenge would be is how do you make the battery more safe? How can you prevent any kind of a situation where the battery can go up in flames? Trying to develop a solid state battery where you don't have any organic solvents. And the challenge there is how can you identify a solid material that will behave like a liquid? Most of the research today is more like a band-aid. What can we do to cover the lithium surface and mask the lithium surface from the incoming lithium so that way it can basically deposit uniformly, but underneath there is the metallic lithium. So it's like, you know, it's like a volcano sitting at the back ready to erupt. We are trying to develop a new anode itself, you know, so it won't be metallic lithium, but it will be another metal that will house the lithium. So the understanding of the structure of the material becomes very important. And doing this while the cell is running is going to be extremely important to understand the nuances of the lithium getting in and reacting to form this alloy. This collaboration and the unique instruments that Malvern Panalytical makes, especially the Empyrean, provides that ability. I mean, we are able to get in situ X-ray analysis done, which will tell us as the cell is running what's happening on the cathode side, on the anode side. The Empyrean with the Gallipix detector, we can identify structures of new and novel materials that we make much more quickly and much more accurately. The benefits to society would be tremendous. Systems being lightweight, systems being more economical, more efficient. You'll be able to run more devices in a single charge of a battery. So I see a lot of benefits to mankind and to society for making it much more safer, much more cost-effective, and much more flexible in terms of being able to use it for a lot more applications.
It's very exciting to be part of the team with Dr. Kumta and the University of Pittsburgh. We're very fortunate that his work and the team's work and the collaboration with our principal scientist, Dr. Scott Speakman, will lead to tremendously innovative and outstanding technologies giving cleaner air and a more sustainable world.